Hello, I'm Ben Mankiewicz. Welcome to Turner Classic Movies, where tonight we're featuring Class Acts. These are movies about inspirational teachers. Up first, from 1988, Stand and Deliver. And look who is here, the star of Stand and Deliver, an Emmy winner, a Golden Globe winner, and a nominee for Best Actor. It is actor and activist Edward James Olmos. Edward, we're particularly grateful for your time in helping us introduce this film, particularly because it's Hispanic Heritage Month.
And it's an honor and privilege to be here with Turner Classic Movies, and I'm very grateful that you've chosen this film. It's one of the films that has given me the most pleasure of making in my lifetime.
So this is a true story of Jaime Escalante, a math teacher at Garfield High School in Los Angeles, who took students who, in the movie you can tell right away, have very little interest in devoting themselves to learning and understanding math, and he wouldn't take their lack of interest for an answer. How did you become associated with the project?
In 1983, I was very fortunate in receiving the Humanitarian Award from the NAACP. At the same event, Jaime was getting Educator of the Year Award. And so we were together there, and that's where I met him. And I had heard, of course, I saw all the news coverage that came out when his situation happened. But that's where I met him, and from that moment on, we became very close and dear friends, and the rest is history.
I think people will notice right in the opening credits that your company, Olmos Productions, is involved in making the movie. So I presume that you weren't—you were clearly not merely hired as an actor. You were involved in getting this movie made from the start after you met Jaime Escalante.
It was so hard to do, Ben. It was one of the hardest movies I've ever tried to make. It took us 5 years. I took it to the studios. I took it to the companies, and they all just said, no, really, make a movie about an inner city school teacher that teaches kids how to take a test. Sorry, man. It's just not concept. It's not quite there. Thank you very much. And they walked me out of the room. I'm every major studio in America did that.
Was some of the resistance the fact that this was an entirely Hispanic cast, that this was
that was the number one issue, man.
I suspect that you expected that to be a hurdle.
Well, yeah. I mean, my whole life has been spent in that. Finally, we got $490,000 from Public Broadcasting, American Playhouse.
Interesting that you've gotten money from public broadcasting. Did that have something to do with the fact that you started Latino Public Broadcasting to tackle stories that predominantly affect the Latino population?
That came after. That's 20 years later. I started Latino Public Broadcasting in 1998. So that was a milestone. I'm trying to get Latino-themed product on public broadcasting, because today Latino Public Broadcasting is producing more hours of Latino themed product than any other production network in America.
Before we show the movie, I'd like to learn a little bit more about your relationship with the subject of the film, Jaime Escalante. Again, this is a true story about a math teacher at Garfield High School. That night you met him getting an award from the NAACP. What struck you first about Jaime Escalante?
Uncanny humbleness and ability to really understand. He was a genius. In Bolivia, where he was born and raised, he was a professor. And then when he came to the United States, he had no credentials because they didn't accept any of his educational system from before. So he came here in the 1960s and started from scratch, going to East LA Community College, then he went to Cal State, and then he went on to get his master's degrees. And all the degrees that he had in Bolivia, he got them here, and then went on to become a creator of software. And that's when the story starts. Is he's leaving his good paying job, which he really did, to do what he really loved, which to become a teacher. He's a very, very smart man. So when you've met him, he didn't impose his intellect on anybody.
Your characterization of Jaime Escalante, the Garfield High School math teacher, is so subdued. I take it after meeting Jaime Escalante, you saw that as the only possible way to play him.
He was with me every single second of every scene that I shot. Now, that's really hard to do. Actors and people in the business will say, you really don't want the person that you're doing around you too much, because then you start to get in the way of making the movie. But in this case, it was paramount, because he could teach me like he taught calculus. He taught me himself. And he was so good at it. All he would do is this. He would be standing there watching the performance, and he'd look at me and he'd go, that was it. He just, one thumb up every single time. And at one point I said to him, towards right before we're going to start shooting, I said, about 7 days before we're going to start shooting, I go, what do you think so far? He goes, well, it's a movie. I go, wait a minute. I said, wait a minute. I go, what do you mean it's a movie? Well, you know, I said, no. Let's sit down and read this together. So we sat down and started reading the script together. Okay. And then all of a sudden he started telling me, well, you know, when I walked into the room the very first time and they started throwing stuff at me, and he started to tell me, you know, things about what he did and how he did them. And I wrote it. I wrote it all down and rewrote the script with him in 6 days. And his input took the screenplay and the story to a very high level.
You stayed connected to him for the duration of his life, including when he got sick.
Yeah, I was with him when he died. Yeah, I was outside. And then we, that's really very emotional. When he passed of cancer. He was 76 years old. He was still too young. He shouldn't have. Sadness that he had to leave. And I got the school to allow me to place him in his classroom in Garfield. That's where his casket was, and people would walk by. And his students came. Everybody stayed for the whole night. Then the following morning, we carried his body down Atlantic Boulevard to the East Los Angeles Community College, where he had gone to college. And we used that football stadium to hold the ceremony, the memorial. It was just quite an experience, and he deserved it.
Edward, thank you for sharing that story. I mean, it means a lot to me to have you tell me that and tell our viewers that. And it's not enough just to call you an actor. You're also an activist. One of the projects that you started was the Los Angeles Latino International Film Festival. What was your motivation there?
The Latino International Film Festival, the Youth Cinema Project, Latino Public Broadcasting, Latino Book and Family Festival are all situations, cultural situations dealing in the arts. I created these back in 1990s, and for the sole purpose of just trying to bring the contributions of Latinos into the mainstream and have people that are Latino have like a glass of water in the middle of the desert, and have people that don't know anything about the culture learn about it and see how much we're the same and how much we're different. And so it's like if you've ever tasted a really good Spanish food or Latin food or you know, Mexican food or Puerto Rican food, or it's delicious. Okay. Each one has their own blend. But same thing with movies and same thing with culture. I mean, each one has its own. So Guatemalan movies, Ecuadorian movies, Central American, South American movies, Spanish, Caribbean movies. We bring them all together and then people come and boy, they're just beautiful. It's a beautiful experience of cultural dynamic.
Edward, again, thank you so much for joining us and sharing these stories about the production and about Jaime Escalante.
Thank you, Ben.